Then we have numerous severe thunderstorms north towards Ponca City. We also have a severe thunderstorm warning in effect for southeastern portions of Ottawa County, northern Delaware County. A very intense thunderstorm at this time, and we're just seeing the potential for some very strong damaging winds in the Fairlane area and east of Afton. So this is going to continue track northeast towards the Kellyville area and Wyandotte. So let me give you a storm track on this cell as it continues to move to the northeast. This will be moving into Hart at 201, West Seneca at 207, and then Seneca at 208. Let's look at velocities on this. We do have some weak low-level rotation with this one. Let me go back to reflectivity. It's just a little disorganized at this point in time, so no imminent threat of a tornadic potential with this cell, but we're going to watch this as this continues to develop and push to the east. Right now, damaging winds would be the primary concern, as it seems to be a little more outflow based, so strong winds heading towards the northern portions of Grand Lake at this time. So that's an intense thunderstorm that bears close watching. We also, again, back to the southwest, we have, let's go back to radar. We have a very intense thunderstorm northern Nowata County right now. This continues to track to the east. But this storm is by far the strongest one in our area. Here's the metro region. Here's Henrietta, and you can see McAllister all quiet right now. But that's going to change as this activity to the west of us continues to push east towards northeast Oklahoma over the next several hours. Matter of fact, I expect this to arrive into Tulsa by about 3 o'clock. The way it's propagating east right now, that's an estimate, so it could be a little 2:30, it could be about 3:30, somewhere in that time frame is when it will be in the metro, and then a little later on from about 4 to 7 o'clock from Tahlequah and Muskogee down to Henrietta, 7 o'clock in McAllister and the Fort Smith area, and then by 9 o'clock this should be all pushing well south of our area. So it is the little bit of an earlier onset, which is not good because this is the peak heating of the day that it's going to be encountering. So we're kind of hoping that we would avoid, but unfortunately that's just not the case. Let's go back into the south and western portions of Osage County. We look at velocities and we're seeing that area of rotation west of Fairfax. Let's look at our rotation detector, and this is the area right here that we'd be watching. Let's look at velocities. And so we do have an area of rotation right here northwest of Fairfax. So we're starting, it's still not that well organized. It's not that intense right now, and that's why we don't have a tornado warning on it just yet. It's still trying to, of course, form and get its act together, and that is something we're going to continue to track. So we're going to watch this. If this continues to intensify more, of course, we're going to go on continuous coverage. But right now, with the severe storm warning still remaining, be prepared, though, to take tornado precautions if this elevates further. And this is something we're going to continue to watch as we go through the afternoon hour. So keep it right here to 2 News Weather. We're going to keep you updated throughout the day. We'll be back with more information as it continues to develop.